I think it's important that everyone understand that the world is full of religious nuts, and religious nuts have agendas. And when you talk about what a religious nut is, I'm pretty sure that Pentecostal Christians are classified as religious nuts. And some of them are very sweet people, but all I'm saying is that's a very, very stupid kind of religious person to have on the Supreme Court. But apparently it's not just Pentecostal people. My parents have supported Billy Graham for a long time, and that means they support Franklin Graham, who is Billy Graham's son. And I guess Michael W. Smith has had a relationship with Billy Graham and Franklin Graham for a long time. And so they decided they were going to throw a prayer party, have a prayer walk, which my mom used to lead prayer walks when she was director of the National Day of Prayer in California. But Billy Graham, well, no, Franklin Graham and Michael W. Smith decided that they're going to have a prayer walk in Washington, D.C., and Mike Pence is going to be invited. So Mike Pence came also. And what they did is they got together and they sang songs together. And what do you do when you sing songs? Great are you, Lord. You force air out of your lungs, right? Even more so than regular talking. And so when you're talking about what COVID-19 is and how it spreads and how it's a respiratory virus, you would think that singing in a large group would be a very, very bad thing to do. But that's what Franklin Graham wants everyone to do, because he trusts God so much. The thing about Franklin Graham is he's a mediocre pastor, and he's basically living off his father's name, and I honestly think his father was very mediocre too. So here's the deal. God is unchangeable, right? That's what you say. God is actuality. God is immutable. Like, there is no potential in God. God is who God is. And God knows everything that's ever going to happen, right? And so can we change God with our prayers? Well, I don't believe we can. Well, God knew I was going to pray, and that's why God was going to respond to that prayer for me. Okay, you can make that argument, but all I'm saying is I think that prayer is for the person that's praying. Like, when I was in jail and I was like, God, I need to pray, and I didn't pray. But I was like, God, I need to pray because I just need to talk to someone. I need to go talk to the Holy Spirit. That prayer wasn't to change God. That prayer was for me, and I didn't actually pray. But all I'm saying is when you pray, I don't think the prayer is to change God, because God is unchangeable, right? So to think that gathering as a group to test the Lord your God, no, I won't get sick. I trust Jesus. Okay, that's good. But the Bible says, do not test the Lord your God. And what you did is you tested the Lord your God for what? For what I think is arrogance. Michael W. Smith wants to make sure he can perform in front of a crowd because he needs that rush. That's what he does. Performing alone is boring. Trust me, I know. That's my whole freaking life, is being alone. It starts to get to you. So what I'm trying to say is COVID-19 doesn't care if you're religious, because germs spread scientifically. Like, God's not going to be like, oh, I'm going to go wipe off that surface for you. Like, I don't believe there's ever been a science experiment that has shown that God would wipe off a surface and remove the germs. Because during the Black Plague, a lot of people died, and they were very, very religious. There was a very high percentage of religious people during the Black Plague, and that's probably one of the reasons that so many people died, because people were believing in all kinds of stupid crap. Well, actually, no one knew what to believe. Nowadays, we do know what to believe, because there's something called science. And I just don't get how a religious person doesn't understand how, if you're standing in a group and you're singing, and then the air is coming out, and you are sick with COVID-19, you don't know it, because you are not even symptomatic, and then suddenly that lands on the back of someone's shoulder, and someone pats them on the back, and then it's on their hand, and so you just killed a really great person. You just killed your hero, Mike Pence, because Mike Pence is everyone's hero. Mike Pence condones this gathering, even though Mike Pence is in charge of the coronavirus task force. All right, so we have two countries. We have China. And who's in charge of their coronavirus task force? A politician, the vice president, right? Or he's the premier. Okay, so who is in charge of the United States coronavirus task force? It's Mike Pence, the vice president. He's the number two, right? And what's the difference between China's leaders and the American leaders. One's a religious nut that wants to go sing in a crowd without a mask, and the other person is an atheist who believes in science and really, really beats the virus. Like, you want to talk about a country where it's difficult to beat the virus? China's a country where it's difficult to beat viruses. That's a huge population. It's very densely populated. They freaking whooped ass. And that's why you can say what you want about, finally remembered his name, Li Keqiang. You can say what you want about that guy, but he worked hard and he beat the virus. Well, he beat it enough. Mike Pence, what's he doing? Don't worry, guys. Trust Jesus. We're going to go put this person on the Supreme Court. This is what she does every weekend. I'm actually really good at speaking in tongues because I spoke in tongues for like a whole 6 months, probably. Not really, but I was around it enough. And the conclusion I reached is that you can have a very, very powerful emotional experience through speaking in tongues, but just because you are having emotions related to large groups of people coming together, like with that are all loving in the same direction, doesn't mean that that experience is actually real. Like, in other words, like, it doesn't mean you're actually experiencing the Holy Spirit, and you're especially not healing someone. And that's where you kind of get the proof. The proof's in the healing services.